Hey guys, welcome back. So if you are new here, please make sure to watch the complete video and then you can later decide on subscribing. So first of all, we will be discussing about the abdominal aorta. So under the posterior abdominal wall and related structures, there are three fascia that will come. That is the psoas fascia, fascia iliaca and thoracolumbar fascia. We have discussed about those fascias under different headings, under different anatomy videos. Make sure to watch that. So along the posterior abdominal wall, we have two great vessels, right? One is the abdominal aorta and the other one is the inferior vena cava. We will discuss them under separate headings. Firstly, today we are going to discuss about the abdominal aorta. So the abdominal aorta is about how much length? It's about 12.5 centimeter long. So it begins as a continuation of the descending thoracic aorta and at the aortic orifice of the diaphragm. So when you are drawing the abdominal aorta, it begins as the descending part of the thoracic aorta, then later on it will end by as the continuation of the common iliac arteries, the right common iliac artery and the left common iliac artery, and these further will divide into the right external common external iliac artery and the internal iliac artery. Then we have the left internal iliac artery and the left external iliac artery. So abdominal aorta, it is continuous as the descending thoracic aorta. It is the continuation of the descending thoracic aorta, and then it will later on continue to become the common iliac arteries and afterwards the external iliac artery and the internal iliac artery. So this is about the abdominal aorta introduction. Where does this descend? Opposite to the T12 vertebra here, and then where does it divide? Here at the level of the L4 vertebra. Here it is descending down at the level of the T12 vertebra, and it is dividing into the right and the left common iliac arteries at the level of the L4 vertebra, and also at the median plane. It is at the median plane that you need to remember. So the measurements, we know it is 12.5 centimeters long, and what about the width of the abdominal aorta? It's up to 2 centimeters in width. And just discussing about the relations, posterior to the abdominal aorta, what do we have? We have the bodies of the upper four lumbar vertebra. We also have the third and fourth lumbar veins. And anterior to the abdominal aorta, we have the celiac plexus, the ganglion, the body of the pancreas, splenic vein. We also have the left renal vein, the root of the mesentery, and also the coils of the small intestine. So these are the anterior and the posterior relations of the abdominal aorta. Now we will discuss about the branches of the abdominal aorta. So in terms of branches of the abdominal aorta, we are dividing it into four parts. So what are those four parts? The three, firstly, they are the three anterior unpaired branches. Three anterior unpaired branches. So they are not paired, they are unpaired, and they lie anterior to the abdominal aorta, and they are three in number, and these are to the viscera of the abdomen. And this you must commonly remember, we have the celiac trunk, then we have the superior mesenteric artery, and then we have the inferior mesenteric artery, So we have three anterior unpaired branches to the viscera. They are the celiac trunk, superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery. So the celiac trunk will arise here, the superior mesenteric artery and the inferior mesenteric artery. So these are the three anterior unpaired branches of the abdominal aorta. The next thing we have is the three lateral paired branches. So what are the next three? They are the three, and they lie lateral to the abdominal aorta, and they are paired branches to the viscera. They are paired and they are branches to the viscera as well. And what are those branches? They are the A, we have the suprarenal artery, then we have the renal artery, and then we have the testicular or ovarian artery. So the branches of the abdominal aorta, they are three in number, they are lateral and they are also paired. We have the suprarenal artery like this, then we have the renal arteries, two big branches, and then we have the testicular or the ovarian arteries, they are gonadal arteries, and they are lateral to the abdominal aorta. They are three in number. We have the suprarenal artery, renal artery and testicular and the ovarian arteries. Next we are discussing about the other two branches. So stick to the video till the end. In terms of the third division, they are the five lateral paired branches. They are five in number. They lie lateral to the abdominal aorta, five lateral, and they are also paired branches to the parietes. Parietes means parietal regions. So what are the those branches? Firstly, we have the inferior phrenic artery. Inferior phrenic artery, which is a branch of the abdominal aorta, and remaining four are the four lumbar arteries. Four lumbar arteries. So we have the five lateral paired arteries to the parietes. The inferior phrenic artery is just at the level of the descending thoracic aorta through the diaphragm, and then we have the four lumbar arteries like this. These are the four lumbar arteries. And finally, the fourth division we'll be discussing about is the three terminal branches. So they are the three terminal branches of the abdominal aorta. And what are the three terminal branches? They are the right common iliac artery, right common iliac artery. Then we have the left common iliac artery, and finally we have the median sacral artery. Median sacral artery. So this is the right common iliac artery, left common iliac artery. We also have a small branch. This is the median sacral artery. So these are the four branches. Four divisions under which we will be studying the abdominal aorta. Quickly, I am revising. We have three anterior paired branches to the viscera. They are the celiac trunk, superior mesenteric artery, and the inferior mesenteric artery. Then we have three lateral paired branches to the viscera. They are the suprarenal artery, renal artery, and the testicular or ovarian artery. Then we have five lateral paired branches to the parietes. We have the inferior phrenic artery and the four lumbar arteries. And finally, we have the three terminal branches. They are the right common iliac artery, left common iliac artery, and the median sacral artery. So this is about the anatomy of the abdominal aorta, its relations, measurements, and also the branches of the abdominal aorta. If you like the video, make sure to subscribe and hit the like button, and also share it among your friends. Thank you so much.